Detective Perkins. Shawn, I talked to Gus. I cannot believe that you lost $7,500 playing roulette. You know what? I don't really want to hear your excuse. I mean, you caught the professional gambler, J.P. Berger, but still, $7,500, Shawn? And now we have to prosecute the guy with 5 million lawyers, which he probably paid for with illegal money anyway. Don't change the subject. Okay, yes, come over for dinner. Ellen? Why do you want Ellen? Just because Gus is coming over does not mean you need to set him up. Some people are okay being single. You know what? Fine, I'll ask her. Actually, she just walked in. Ellen, would you like to have dinner with Shawn and I?
Sure.
Well, she said yes, so I'll see you at 7. All right, goodbye. Don't believe the lie. Don't buy into what they sell you. It'll only make you cry. I've been there and I'm here to tell you that what you got inside your soul, deep down, you know the truth won't hide. Don't believe the lie. Don't believe the lie. Oh, here comes the morning sun. It's shining down on what you've done. What was that?
What was what?
Show me your left hand.
Why?
Show me your left hand now, Ellen! But I don't even know what to say to you. You met him for one night. 4 hours, Ellen! Where did you even find a ring in 4 hours? Did a porcupine fall out of the sky and give Gus the ring, which he then in turn gave to you?
Well, after you went home, Gus decided to take me home, and we had to walk past the mall, and it just kind of happened.
You know what? We're not even going to talk about this. We're just going to pretend that this never happened.
Well, I'm not going to pretend.
John and I knew each other for 3 years. 3 years before he got the courage to ask me on a date. Just last week, we finally decided that we were an actual couple. Over 3 years, Ellen! One night, 4 hours? Ellen!
Okay. We need to concentrate on J.P. Berger.
All right. Berger is refusing to speak without his lawyers present, and he's not going to say anything with his lawyers present, and we're never going to find his underground gambling ring.
Well, not all of his activities were illegal. The tournament where we caught him cheating was completely legitimate. Otherwise, I don't think your boyfriend would have been involved.
Well, you don't really know my boyfriend very well, but I guess you're right. Any casino on Indian land regulated by both the California Nation's Indian Gaming Association and the National Indian Gaming Commission is legal in the state of California.
Right, but according to Penal Code 337X, it is unlawful to cheat at any gambling game in a gambling establishment.
Really? They actually made a whole code about it?
No, it's a section of a code, 337X. See, that's what the X is for.
I'm really not sure if I believe you, but I have other work to do. So why don't you memorize the rest of the Penal Code now?
Actually, I'm a little too busy memorizing my wedding vows. Hi, Diane. So, I was doing some research on professional gambling, and according to California state law, professional gambling is participating in gambling and having, other than by virtue of skill or luck, a greater chance of winning or a lesser chance of losing than one or more of the other participants.
Which, of course, Berger had. His partner was marking cards with invisible ink, which he read with his special pink sunglasses. I think that qualifies as a greater chance of winning and a lesser chance of losing.
Since it's the first time we caught him, it's a class 1 misdemeanor. But if we catch him doing it...
I know, it's a class 5 felony. I'm a detective, I do know that. But what is the chance that we catch him again? Do you know what Shawn had to go through to get anywhere near catching Burr? He needs to go to prison, and he needs to go there for a long time and take his stupid sunglasses with him. You, Alan, are the people's lawyer, so why don't you get him off the streets? He needs to go to prison now.
I want Burger to go to jail as much as you do, but the law is the law, and people have rights, and just because you're mad that your boyfriend lost all of his money and my fiancé's money is no reason to ignore his right to counsel. He has just as much right to his lawyers as the people do to me.
But if we can catch the other professional gamblers, then we can get them off the streets and stop more crime.
It doesn't matter how many people we put in jail. People are going to keep gambling until we find another way for them to get money.
It's not the poor that gambles. It's people like Burger. And we need to put them in jail so they can't drag anyone else down with them.
We can argue about this as long as we want. We're never going to agree. But can't agree on one thing. Burger needs to go to jail, and we just need to find a way to put him there. Ellen Feverly.
Hey, Gus. How are you?
Me too. Advice? I guess. Another gambling case? What are the odds of that? Okay, Gus. You don't have to laugh that much. I'm already marrying you. Shawn wants to open a casino? He's not Native American. There is no way he is Cherokee. He wants to go by dancing water buffalo? There aren't even water buffalo in North America. He can't buy Indian land. Has he told Diane about this? Of course not. Why would he do that? What do you mean you guys have a slot machine in your office? You could go to prison. I'm not going to marry you in a California state prison. According to California state gambling laws regarding slot machines, being the owner, lessee, or occupant of any room, shed, tenement, tent, booth, building, float, vessel, place, stand, enclosure, or grounds, or any part thereof, whether for gain, hire, reward, or gratuitously, or otherwise permits the space to be used or occupied for any purpose or in any manner prohibited by paragraph 1, 2, 3, or 4. Paragraphs 1, 2, 3, and 4 are... Okay. Sorry. Just disassemble it, put it in a box, and ship it to another state. That's legal. Okay. Back to shop. Excuse me. Dancing Water Buffalo's casino. What else did he want to do so I can tell you how illegal it is? Yes, lotteries are also illegal of any kind. Do not make me go on my rant again.
Who's dancing water buffalo?
Gus, I have to go.
Who is dancing water buffalo?
Well,
It's Shawn, isn't it? He wants to open an Indian casino, an Indian casino!
I'm telling Gus to tell Shawn that he's not a Native American and that he will go to prison.
Yeah. And I'll have no problem being the arresting officer on that one. 3 years. 3 stupid years! Anyway, what I came to talk to you about was the Unlawful Internet Gambling Enforcement Act of 2006.
I heard about that. The World Trade Organization is claiming that this violates international trade law.
Right. But the Department of Justice is claiming that internet gambling was already illegal, because all interstate gambling is illegal under the Wire Act. Anyway, if they break the law, they go to jail for 5 years and they never get to gamble again.
Well, yeah, but the problem with the WTO is that many small islands make their money off of internet gambling.
Even so, it's strange, because this act was put on an entirely unrelated bill called the Safe Port Act, dealing with port security.
Well, you wouldn't want to gamble with that.
I'm just trying to figure out how we can put Burger in prison. I'm just looking at all the different angles. Maybe you could do that instead of talking to your fiancé about my boyfriend and his Indian casino.
We're probably going to have to plea bargain and let him go with a misdemeanor.